Hi guys. So I want to start off. First of all, you guys are going to need a marker and a piece of paper. The reason I don't say pen is because lately it hasn't been showing up over Zoom. So if you could grab a marker and just a blank piece of paper, that would be awesome. Just give a few seconds. Right, while people are getting stuff together, does anybody have a favorite spot in nature that they can go to and just relax? And just forget about their problems. It can be anything from like your front porch to, up in the mountains. Does anyone want to share? I can share mine. I run, there's a state park down the street from me, and I run down there, and right now it's autumn, and so the leaves are really pretty, and there's a bridge that goes over a little river. And whenever I'm running, I just like to stop and I just like to stand there and just look out. And sometimes you can see like heron, you can see beaver, and it's really, really pretty. Does anybody else have something like that they want to share? Desiree?
Close to where I live, there's a private beach. Like, it's a super small beach, and I like going there because there's like cliffs off the side of it and like dunes on the opposite side. So when you look, it's kind of like ending on one side and ending on the other with just ocean in the middle. So that's my serene spot.
That's really pretty. Does anyone else have something that they want to share? Sam, did I see your hand?
Oh yeah, I just didn't hear you say Sam. Back home, there's a big beach near my house, and there's a big seawall on that beach, and it's really nice to just go and sit on that seawall, really at any time of day, either when it's sunny out or even at night. It's nice to just sit there sometimes.
Yeah, that sounds really nice. All right, I hope everybody has like this picture in their head. You guys know what an ecosystem is, right? How everything in the natural area kind of relates to each other. So I want you to think about that place that you have in your head, and I want you to think about how everything in that natural spot relates to each other. So my example, I said that there were beaver, there were heron in that river. It's because they both, the beaver and heron, they both eat the fish that live in the river. The fish feed off of it's in the forest. There's a lot of bacteria and stuff that grows in there. That's what the fish will feed off of. And like the trees, they are all really close to the water's edge, so they grow really tall. And the leaves are always really bright because they get a lot of sunlight from being right next to the river. So can you guys think about that? And if anyone wants to share about how everything in their little ecosystem relates to each other, that would be really great. If you don't want to share, if you could just think about it. All right. Are we good? Anyone have any questions? Okay. All right. So I want you guys to close your eyes and I'm going to read you this poem. Right. This is called The Lakes. Do you guys want to read along with me or do you want to just. No, you just want to listen? Okay. All right. What should be over burrowed under my skin in heart-stopping waves of hurt? I've come too far to watch some name-dropping sleaze tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong here, and my beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off, but not without my muse. So who can tell me what the theme and general idea of that poem is? What is a Windermere Peak, Cassandra?
I don't necessarily know what that is, but I was just going to say what I thought it meant. So it's basically saying how like there's tough times. That's where I perceived it. How like there's different situations that you go through, but you always have like this one spot that you can just sit and think and be with yourself.
Yeah, exactly. All right. So I'm gonna split you guys into groups. Those are the lyrics from the song that we're about to listen to. So this song is about exactly what Sandra was talking about, being in a place in nature that you can just forget about everything else and just be absorbed in the beauty of it. So when we listen to the song, I want you guys to really listen to the instruments that are a part of this. So I'm gonna split you into groups, and each group is gonna look for a specific instrument. So I'm gonna split you off. So Mary Rose, Sam and Sophia, Sambolinsky and Sophia. You guys are gonna try to see if you can find the guitar. Let's see. Desiree, Will, and Greg, you guys are going to find the strings. Evan, Cassandra, and Grace, you guys are going to look for the harp. And who haven't I called yet? Sam Day, Andrew, Thaddeus, you guys are going to look for, there's like a clarinet. So you guys are going to look for those, and they don't all come in at the same time. So make sure that you write down on your paper what lyric the instrument comes in and what lyric it goes out on. Does that make sense? Okay. Can you guys see that? Can you guys see my screen? Yeah?
Yes, we can.
Okay. Let me know if you can hear this. Because it just told me that it might not work, so. Can you hear that? All right, perfect.
Stopping waves of hurt. I've come too far to watch some name dropping slates tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and I'm beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off.
All right, could you guys hear that? Was that okay? Were people able to figure out what part their instrument comes in on? Or do you want to listen to it one more time? One more time? Okay. Right, so figure out where it comes in on, and also I want you to think about if you can try to figure out the flow and the general contour of the instrument and what it's doing. Here we go.
What should be over, burrowed under my skin, and heart-stopping waves of hurt. I've come too far to watch some name-dropping slates tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and I'm beloved, neither do you. Look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off, but not without my muse.
All right. Were people able to get that time? Yeah. Anyone not able to get that? Okay, so can someone from the harp group tell me where the harp, you can hear the harp, like what lyrics it comes in on? Who was in the harp group? Grace, Evan, Cassandra? Were you guys able to figure it out? You can just unmute yourself.
I mean, it was very quiet in the background. It either came in on the word take or the word peak. I wasn't, yeah, I wasn't sure.
Yeah, that's right. Yep. All right. The strings, could you guys hear the cello and like the general orchestra sound in the background? Who was in that group? Who was in the group that was looking for the strings? Okay. We'll move on then. Who was in the group that was looking for the guitar? Can you guys raise your hands? Sam, Arrows, Sophia? Were you guys able to listen for it? Could you figure out where it came in? Was it
I couldn't like pinpoint it exactly.
Yeah, that's okay. Do you think it was maybe more towards the beginning, that first phrase, or was it more towards the second part of the song?
To me, it sounded like it was there kind of the whole time, but it became more noticeable when the chorus started.
Yeah, yeah, excellent. Okay, the last one was like the clarinet sound. Who was in that group? Can you guys tell me where that came in? Were you guys able to hear it?
I wasn't able to find a specific lyric where I could hear it come in. I could just hear it in the background, kind of blending with that stringy orchestra sound.
Yeah, it was mostly, so like I know we didn't really find out where like the orchestra sound was, but the clarinet was kind of intermixed with that, right? But essentially not everything came in at once. Things were kind of paired together or they came in at different times, right? So I want you guys to, with the people in your groups, talk amongst yourselves and see if you can come up with something in nature that that specific part describes. So for example, if I was to do the vocal line, right, and I'm analyzing the vocal line and thinking about the way that it moves and the general contour of the melody, I would say that it sounds like a bird. And this is where your pen and paper is going to come in, and I'm going to draw a bird on my pen and with my pen and paper, because that represents the vocal line, the way that it dives and the way that it kind of moves along. So we can listen to it one more time so you guys can really listen for that and see if you can talk amongst yourselves and your group mates and see what kind of natural thing this instrument might describe. Does anybody have any questions about that? Does that make sense? Yeah? Okay, we're gonna listen to it one more time. Oh, and make sure that you're drawing it on your paper.
What should be over burrowed under my skin and heart-stopping waves of hurt. I've come too far to watch some name-dropping slaves tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and not beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm sad and all, but not without my muse.
Okay. So take maybe a minute or two with your partners and see if you can all kind of come to a collective decision on what's something in nature that this sounds like, all right? And draw that on your paper. I'm going to play it one more time in case we need it.
What should be over burrowed under my skin and heart-stopping waves of hurt. I've come too far to watch some name-dropping slaves tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and my beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm sad and all, but not without my muse.
raise your hand if you're done. Raise your hand if you need another minute. Are people having trouble with identifying what it might sound like? Or are we just drawing? Are we done? Are we good? Yeah, we're good. Okay. Can someone from the group thinking about the harp, can you guys tell me what you guys drew or show me what you drew?
So we kind of said two things. So I said, like, collectively, we were kind of agreeing with it, but that picture, but it's sort of like a hilltop and someone was like running through flowers. And then Evan also pointed out that it also sounds like a mountain and that there was water flowing on the side of the mountain.
Yes. Awesome. So we got a mountain. We got someone running down a hill. All right. Someone from the strings? Desiree?
So I think the first time why it was a little difficult to pinpoint where it was is because I think it was hard to differentiate between the harp and then the string instrument groupings. But this time around, I was able to do it. What it reminded me of, what I drew, was a sunrise, because what it sounded like to me was there was the harp and then the strings kind of led up to this, like, glimmering landscape. So that's what I heard.
Yeah. Will?
Yeah, there was also some, like, high strings that kind of represent, like, kind of birds in the sky.
Yeah,
when it kind of, like, flattered in the sky and everything. So.
Excellent. Yeah. All right, from the group with the clarinet and the saxophone. Yeah, you guys can just unmute and talk about it.
I know if mine was similar to the string section that Desiree said, where I just kind of heard this really calming background that, for me, like, I visualized almost like a sunrise over, like, a really still lake.
Yeah.
And
yeah, it's really pretty. All right, and the last group was the, did I already say the harp? Well, it hasn't gone. Yeah, you guys wanna show what you guys were talking about?
So me, Sophie, and Mary Rose had the guitar.
Oh, guitar.
We were having a little bit of trouble figuring out what it sounded like, but we kind of came to that it kind of sounded like rain almost, like the way that it was strumming, or like rain, like falling into like water and stuff like that.
Yeah, that's really interesting. I totally see that. All right, so I just drew you guys this little ecosystem. So we had the strings, we had the rain from the guitar, we had the lake, we had the hills. So you guys see how all these things that you thought represented the instruments, they all kind of relate to each other in an ecosystem, right? That's because all of the instruments relate to each other in the song. Do you guys know what the word texture means? Yeah? What is texture? Can somebody describe it? Does anyone have a definition for texture? Yeah, Desiree, Will. You guys just talk about it.
Texture in a literal sense would mean how something feels like beneath your fingertips, and like texture in a musical sense would be how the instrumentation as a whole, what it sounds like, things like
that. Yeah, absolutely. So it's about how everything in the musical piece relates to each other. And you can see that these instruments, they resemble how everything in an ecosystem relates to each other, right? So that's what texture is. And so how does this relate to the overall theme of the song? What was the overall theme of the song? You said it earlier, Will.
Yeah, because Cassandra mentioned it before, finding a place of serenity, of, you know, just calmness and stillness and a place where you can relax. And so I think all these instruments kind of laid that out by just how calm they were, how they slowly came in and kind of grew into this sound, which is probably just the sound of nature all around you as you begin to listen to everything around you, and it all comes into one.
Yeah, absolutely. I like how you use the word grow. If you think about a tree, the way that it grows upwards and then it branches out. And that's essentially what the instruments are doing in this piece. So I want you guys to think about that next time that you're listening to something, or next time that you're out in nature. Think about how it's not just music, it's music as it relates to everything else. So thank you so much.